Hi, everyone. We're on the red carpet and we're meeting one of our honorees tonight. It's Amy Lee from Evanescence. Hi, Amy.
Hi, John. Thanks for having me.
Well, thanks for being here for this virtual red carpet, in the middle of doing everything from home.
I know, it's crazy.
Congratulations.
It's a nice break from that. It's nice to pretend that life can move forward. I can't wait until we can do these things in person again.
Yes. I would imagine as a musician, touring is probably one of those things that.
Number one, besides seeing all my family that I haven't seen, being able to play music in the flesh with that crowd. Oh, I can't wait.
Yeah. We're real close.
I know. I think so.
Real close. I think so too.
Yeah.
So I want to ask you about what it's like to, you've received Grammys. Your roster is impressive. Of course, there are other awards such as Rock Goddess and all that. But what does it mean to you when you receive an award from, a group that is dedicated to women professionals?
That's really special. I can't count on a hand how many awards I have like that. This is kind of standing out on its own. I think that's wonderful. What an incredible thing to do. There are so many incredible women to honor, but there's so many incredible women musicians to honor. And in our place, this being about rock, I don't think this could come at a better time. This is about using of our voice. I mean, I know I'm not trying to plug my song. It's funny because that's been this theme in this time for me, and it would have been whether or not it ended up coming out in a lyric, but it makes sense that it did. It's just become such a time for people to stand up and say, this is who I am, and I'm proud to be who I am, and I should be able to be who I am and be proud of that. We all should. I don't know how, I'm sure I'm not articulating that great, but we are here and we've been here and we're proud to be here. And I'm so proud to be standing beside so many other incredible women who I love. Lizzie Hale, I mean, I know obviously she's hosting tonight, is one of my best, most favorite women. and I'm always proud to stand beside her. But apart from that, I mean, all the others, Nancy Wilson, so many more. It's a great honor. And it's about time we had a little moment to celebrate something.
And you guys have been working on, a new recording that's going to be released, which is very exciting.
Yes, I know.
The Bitter Truth, right? The Bitter Truth.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
What is the bitter truth?
God,
every day. It's been a bitter year, so tell us the bitter truth.
I know, every day I have a new thing that I'm like, that's the bitter truth. I right now, it's hard because it's a lot of things that aren't funny or smiley to say. But I think the fact that we're facing a lot of these realities is really healthy, and we have to. There has to be a moment for us to go, okay, we're broken. This is messed up. And it's not going to change if we just keep pretending like it isn't here. So facing these injustices with sexism and racism and so much more that are happening around the world, it's time. And the bitter truth is that we do have to go through these growing pains and face this in order to get to a better place. So as hard as it is and as scary as it has been at times, I'm looking forward to a better tomorrow for not just myself, but for my son and for the people coming after us. I'm very grateful to have made it this far. And this time, more than anything, has given us all a chance to look at what we have to be grateful for. And there's so much. So thank you. And I'm so grateful to stand among so many incredible, powerful women who have influenced our world in a positive way.